And I don't know if they thought that they would never be caught. I don't know if they did not see the coverage of this, the global coverage. But we do have some facts about the two that we've learned since their arrest. We knew that he is a former auto body shop worker. He grew up in Weaverville near Reading. He's got family in the Whittier area. We know that he often shared content on social media about cars and guns, posted several pictures and videos of himself shooting an array of assault-style rifles out in the field somewhere, pistols outdoors and at a shooting range. One of the weapons he displayed was capable of delivering the shot that killed Aiden, and I just wonder if the weapon that they recovered was the gun used to kill Aiden, or was it like the gun that was used to kill Aiden, and will that matter?
Yeah, they haven't said if they recovered the slug, if in fact they know what kind of gun it was, which, listen, is not important to, it doesn't change the story. It's their job, and it's their, you know, it's a huge investigative tool for them to have that information.
Remember, though, when we were watching this live, when they shut down the 55, we were in here, and we watched as the police officers formed a single file line and walked the length of that freeway, hoping, as I believe you said, to find that slug, find
the shell casing. Because at the time, the headlines were about these pellet shootings.
Right.
And when we were seeing that, we didn't know, first of all, we didn't know that the little boy died. We didn't know the nature of the shooting. We just knew that there was yet another shooting on the freeway. So for them to actually look for a shell casing would have been significant. Listen, I don't know how he was holding the gun. Nobody knows. The shell casing likely ended up inside the car with him as they drove away.
He worked at an auto body shop in Corona, reportedly left in January, but in recent weeks he was texting, asking for his job back. It looks like Wynn Lee grew up in Diamond Bar. She went to Diamond Bar High, Mount San Antonio College. Not much other than that to learn about these two. It looks like she may have just picked the wrong man.
Listen, one of the questions that we've had repeatedly is, since the description of the vehicle came out, this 2018 or 19 Volkswagen station wagon, how many of those vehicles could exist in Southern California? I mean, that's a really specific, station wagons don't exist on large scale anymore. And they're not sold in large scale anymore.
But I just
the CHP, well, the CHP says there are about 20,000 such cars in the immediate four county area in Southern California that they were able to narrow that number down to 130. That blows my mind. I don't know what the umbrella is that they're using to come up with a 20,000 number.
Well, maybe they were purchased.
White Volkswagen?
I don't know. That doesn't sound accurate. I can't believe that this couple was living in Costa Mesa, right? You would think in Costa Mesa that would have like the most saturation of this story of people looking out for this car, but it took that long for people to find them, even though this car is so rare. I guess not that rare.
They did say that the car was found in Whittier in a garage that belonged to one of Marcus's relatives, and that relative had been away from home. So whether he had permission to put it in there, he went and snuck in and just put the car in there, whatever.
Had that relative been away from home, though? I don't know. That sounds a little shady.
Well, listen, even if you're the relative and you're like, hey, here's a weird story, why are you trying to hide a white Volkswagen station wagon? I saw something on the news about that.
See, I heard the relative might have been a grandma, which made me think like, oh, maybe she
had no clue.
Yeah, she either had no clue or maybe was at a facility of some sort, but that was her home. I don't know.
Well, and grandmothers, you can do no wrong in their eyes. She would never believe that her grandson would be capable of that.
My grandma would have hung me out. You kidding? I did something stupid like that. Hung me out.
Well, no, I just don't think that.
Grabbed me by my ear and walked me.
I think that the grandma probably, even if it was in her purview, even if she did see the news or hear the news about this, I think it would never occur to her that that would be her grandson.
Yeah. I hope on her behalf. All right, coming back, the LA Police Commission is looking at some new rules for armed officers off duty getting a little buzzed. We'll talk about alcohol rules for armed off-duty officers when we come back.
Gary and Shannon will continue in for Handle. Jennifer Jones-Lee has the news. The search continues for the hit-and-run driver who killed three girls and critically injured a fourth in the Lucerne Valley. Two of the four girls were in wheelchairs when they were hit from behind by a pickup truck Saturday night. Some Amazon Echo devices are now sharing their internet connection with neighbors. It started yesterday. The plan is called Amazon Sidewalk. The goal is to extend the range of devices. And the Tribeca Film Festival kicks off in New York today with in-person movie screenings. We'll take a look at your drive with VKFI in the Sky next.
We all have wished at one time or another if we could just do two things at the same time. Well, if you're about to refinance or purchase a new home, here are two things you should absolutely do at the same time. Apply with at least two lenders. Mark Tice here from HMS Capital. Having two loans processed at the same time accomplishes a couple of important things. First, it maintains continuing competition for you, the customer, right up to the finish line. This results in a lower interest rate that saves you money. Second, it improves your chances of a successful transaction by eliminating the dependence on a single lender. HMS Capital requires no advance fees to apply, there's no appraisal fee, and no credit fee. With our razor-sharp interest rates, we are completely confident that no matter how many lenders you apply with, we will win your business. So call HMS Capital today and let us show you how doing two things at once really can save you money. Call HMS Capital at 833-255-5698. 833-255-5698. That's 833-255-5698. Or go to HMSCapital.com.
HMS Capital Funding is a DBA of Golden Empire Mortgage, Inc. NMLS ID number 2427. HMS Capital Funding is licensed in California by the Department of Business Oversight under the Residential Mortgage Lending Act. License number 413-0360. Equal housing lender.
Go to our website at HMSCapital.com.
Lowe's is your go-to for great gardening values every day. Select bagged mulch is now just $2.88 a bag. Shop online and pick up in-store. Lowe's, home to the best part of summer. Selection and product availability vary by location while supplies last, U.S. only.
SoCal weather from KFI, partly cloudy with highs mid-60s to the low 80s. This report is brought to you by Lowe's. Let's check out this wreck on the 10.
Work to do in Baldwin Park. It's 10 Net East connector to the northbound 605. There's a truck on its side on that transition road. So if nothing else, you will find that that is a very slow connection for you. KFI in the Sky is sponsored by injury attorney Superwoman, Superlawyer.com. Jeff Ball, you ride on some of the 101.
Right, not too bad, too. The Hollywood freeway section of the 101 leading to San Fernando Valley. It's a little slow on the 170 approaching that interchange. But going uphill, there was a problem in Lancashire. All gone, don't you worry about it. All lanes open up and over the hill. It gets slowed about Vermont going down to the 4 level. Not too bad. Now, a little bit more good news now. If you were going to continue South 101 and then go east on the 10, going out towards East LA and Cal State, all that, it was a little bit of a grass fire on the edge of Boyle Heights. It's all gone. Fire's out. Fire department left, so all lanes are open, so a pretty easy drive. Another tough one, though, is this North 5 coming through the East LA interchange. Doesn't get better until you get past the Glendale Freeway. After that, pretty good drive into Burbank. Injured in an accident, visit Superwoman, Superlawyer.com. Jeff Barr, KFI in the Sky.
In Corona, 91 westbound after Green River, somebody broke down in the right lane. Expect that delay at Grand. KFI in the Sky helps get you there faster. I'm Robin Banks.
This report is sponsored by Rocket Mortgage. When you're ready to buy a new home and want a mortgage lender who can help you plan with certainty, Rocket can. Get personalized loan options, closing costs, and tax estimates all in real time? Rocket can. Rocket Mortgage.
Could you use a change in scenery? Why not make yours happen right at home with a quick outdoor makeover your family can enjoy for years to come? From renovating that old crack driveway to adding an inviting new walkway or patio, you'd be amazed at how much a simple outdoor update can completely transform your outlook and your lifestyle. I'm Larry Green, CEO of System Pavers, America's number one designer and installer of elegant outdoor living systems. Our Big Change sales event is going on now to help you save a bundle on your brand new view. Call 800-8004 right now to lock in exclusive low prices and special financing. From driveways, patios, synthetic turf, lighting, and more, our experts are ready to help you make a change today. Get started by calling 800-8004 and save like never before during System Pavers Big Change Sales Event. 800-PAVE-004 or systempavers.com.
All orders must be placed by June 30th, and installation must commence within 60 days of sale. Financing subject to third-party approval. See website for full offer details. Contractor's license, 661-575.
Summer is here and it is getting hot.
Hey, you know what else is hot? The money that I'm saving with SolarMax technology.
Without upfront cost?
Yeah, that's because SolarMax does everything themselves under one roof right here in Southern California. exceptional quality control and no middleman.
Right now, Solar Max is only $69.98 a month, which includes a solar panel system and a home battery, and an APR as low as 0.99%. This offer expires June 30th.
Dial #250 on your cell and say Solar Max, or go to solarmaxtech.com. Monthly payment available on approved credit. CSLB number 9720.
Are you worried about refinancing your mortgage only to find a better rate later? Introducing the No Regret Refinance from Network Capital Funding Corporation. Mortgage rates are near all-time lows, and Network Capital is now offering one of our lowest 30-year fixed rates ever, 2.75% with a 2.76% APR with no points or lender fees. Incredible! Our unique process is fast, simple, and secure. And right now, the Network Capital 30-year fixed rate is 2.75% with a 2.76% APR. Now, today's low rates won't last, so talk to us about the No Regret Refinance today. Call the experts at Network Capital right now. Call 800-500-1-HIT. That's 800-500-1-HIT. As in home run. Call now and save big on your refi. 800-500-1-HIT. 800-500-1448.
NMLS ID 11712. Visit NMLSConsumerAccess.org. Licensed by the California Department of Financial Protection and Innovation under the Finance Lender Law. Number 603787. An equal opportunity lender. Loan amounts $500,000 and greater. Rates subject to change. Need credit approval. Call 800-500-1448 for additional cost information.
Hey, business owners. What if you could cut all your business expenses in half? It would be amazing, right? Well, you could start by switching to Spectrum Business. When you switch, you get the best internet and phone service for half of what you're paying now. Call 888-489-2212 today, and you'll get faster internet, proven reliability, and the most value. Only with Spectrum Business. Call 888-489-2212 today. Spectrum Business. No nonsense, just business. Restrictions apply. Call for details.
Looking for your next investment? Want to cash out of stock market risk and volatility? Here are 8 reasons to consider NRIA's proven real estate development fund. Monthly cash flow payouts of 10% annualized and bonuses to 21% targeted. We strategically locate in lower risk, high demand areas people are moving to. New construction is short on supply. Real estate affords diversification and safety from stock market risk and volatility. We have substantial property assets selling out every month, supporting your investment. Our short and long-term strategy provides for steady returns today and major upside targets. Our buildings are socially responsible, environmentally friendly, and pandemic hardened. We are an industry leader with a 15-year proven track record. Hedge against inflation and receive steady cash flow. Start your due diligence at NRIA.net or call 800-800-1414. That's 800-800-1414.
An offer of securities is only made by the NRIA Private Placement Memorandum. Read it first. Past performance does not guarantee future results. NRIA is a real estate development firm. Learn more at NRIA.net.
KFI AM 640.
An iHeart radio station.
24-hour news. More stimulating talk.
Can't make it all make sense, so I'm gonna stand right here on the edge of this pit.
KFI AM 640 live everywhere on the iHeartRadio app. And for Handel today, he's coming up at 8 o'clock, by the way. He's going to come up and explain what's going on with him, where he's been, his adventures.
Yeah,
you made it sound Indiana Jones
like. Well, I'm hoping for a Temple of Doom like story. I don't know if we'll get one, but he's always entertaining. I bet there have been some adventure things that have gone on.
President Biden is on his way to the UK. He's got a 8-day trip, I believe, through Europe. UK is the first stop. The big deal is going to be his meeting with Vladimir Putin next week. California's workplace regulators have set a special meeting for tonight. So if anybody's interested, Cal OSHA is getting back together. They have to figure out how they're going to do the masking and social distancing requirements for workplaces in the state because of the way the state and the CDC have said things can go moving forward. And of course, next Tuesday is big personal responsibility day here in the state of California, and they're going to try to screw something up again tonight.
Well, the LA Times continues its war on the LAPD, apparently uncovered, 4 incidences in the past 15 years where off-duty cops have gotten in trouble while drinking and carrying their weapons.
Yeah, but no, it says that serious cases continue to pile up.
No, that's not what I'm seeing here in this lengthy report by the LA Times. But nevertheless, the LA Police Commission yesterday said it will consider changing LAPD policy to restrict the use of alcohol by armed off-duty officers.
Now, as of right now, the LAPD does not have any explicit policy when it comes to off-duty officers wearing weapons getting drunk or intoxicated to any degree. And obviously that comes with probably make you uncomfortable if you thought that somebody was getting hammered while they're carrying a Glock 9mm on their shoulder.
No, but I mean, you know what comes to mind is the borderline shooting. A number of off-duty officers there were not drunk, did have their weapons on them, and were able to jump into action because of that. Most officers are not going to go and get wasted and whip out their gun and start
playing around. Even just waving it around.
Right.
I mean, and part of it is because of the training that they get on a regular basis for what the weapon is and what it does and why you have it and when you use it. I mean, simple things like that. In California, for example, my concealed carry permit, if I had one, does not allow me to have any alcohol, period, while carrying a firearm.
There are only four states that have that rule. Alaska, Arizona, California, and D.C. that say
those are wildly disparate states, too.
Right? Yeah, but those are the only four. Most states have not even addressed it in state statutes.
Now, specifically when it comes to law enforcement agencies that do have policies, for example, sheriff's deputies in L.A. and Orange County cannot carry weapons while under the influence of alcohol. That's what those policies say. In San Francisco, by the way, San Francisco says police officers shall not consume alcoholic beverages or be impaired while armed. It doesn't even talk about the level of intoxication when it comes to alcohol. It says you can't drink at all while you're armed. And in San Francisco, they say a diminished ability to perform your duties comes at a blood alcohol content of more than 0.015. Not 0.08, which is the, you know, drinking the limit for driving. 0.015.
That's like a sip.
That's like a sniff. That's not even, it tastes, it burns on the lips. That's about what a 0.015 would be.
During the commission's virtual meeting yesterday, LAPD Chief Michael Moore brought up the Times article, called it serious and concerning. He said, "The misuse of alcohol by officers is a very serious matter and one we pay a great deal of attention to, and that LAPD officers who have been found to have misused alcohol, resulting in terrible outcomes, have faced swift and certain consequences." I like the delicate dance that Michael Moore is doing, saying that this is serious, but also we handle it. In the few instances where this pops up, we handle it. It's not a pervasive issue in the LAPD. It did not deserve the ink the LA Times gave it.
Yeah, it makes it sound like guys are going to bars and women, just going to bars and then shooting willy-nilly out in the back alley or something like that and accidentally killing people. And that's not what's happening. The officers are punished if they do anything that is unbecoming when they're off duty. They can be punished whether they're drunk or not. You can be punished for what you do off duty when you become an LAPD officer. I am surprised. I didn't realize the LAPD did not have a rule that explicitly bars it, or like the others, you know, at least set up limitations for it.
Right.
And even if that does change, even if there is a policy that's put in place, that doesn't necessarily mean that officers are going to follow it to the T. You know?
No.
And they're going to take some personal responsibility.
Especially officers that have put in 30 years.
Yeah. I would imagine that guys that have been on the, and women who've been on the force for a long time, are going to be able to say, listen, I know how to control myself. I can be in control of a situation with a couple of beers in.
I feel safer when I'm in a bar with my officer friends who are armed. I'm not naming names.
I agree.
All right, coming up next. Authorities seize millions of dollars worth of pot from a bunch of illegal grows in the Antelope Valley. We'll get Steve Gregory on for his exclusive get when we return.
Gary and Shannon will continue in for Handle today. Jennifer Jones Lee is in the newsroom.
The LA County Democratic Party Central Committee has voted to call for Sheriff Villanueva's resignation. Last night's vote comes 10 days before the first anniversary, the fatal shooting of 18-year-old Andres Guardado by a sheriff's deputy near Gardena. Party Chairman Mark Gonzalez says it was an example of brutality by law enforcement. LA Democrats endorsed Villanueva in 2018 when he became the first Democrat to be elected sheriff in 138 years. News is brought to you by American Vision Windows. Federal prosecutors have filed charges against a retired nun who has agreed to plead guilty to fraud and money laundering charges. In her plea agreement, 79-year-old Mary Cooper admits stealing $835,000 from St. James Catholic School in Torrance, where she was principal. Prosecutors say she used the money for herself and to gamble. A fire in a homeless encampment in downtown L.A. spread to a nearby building before firefighters were able to put it out. The L.A. Fire Department says crews found a large homeless encampment burning about 11 last night. They forced their way into the commercial building next door and found it was on fire, too. L.A. County Fire says the crews put out both fires within an hour. A report shows the rich are better at dodging the tax collector.
The nonprofit investigative journalism organization ProPublica has found the richest 25 Americans pay less than average folks. The report shows Amazon founder Jeff Bezos paid no income tax in 2007 and 2011. Tesla founder Elon Musk's income tax bill was zero in 2018, and financier George Soros went three straight years without paying federal income tax. The report shows many of the ultra-rich use legal tax strategies to shrink their federal tax bill to nothing or close to it. Deborah Mark, KFI News.
And a rehabilitated 120-pound sea turtle in Florida has been released in honor of World Ocean Day. Marine wildlife experts say the 20-year-old turtle named Parrothead was found about 2 months ago after being involved in a boating accident. Parrothead had serious injuries to its shell and spinal cord, but yesterday he was able to waddle back to his home in the ocean. We've got a hazard on the 73. This is such a massive hazard, it's taken Robin extra time to
turn the microphone
out.
On.
Well, there's that. Because you were hard at work.
I was hard at work. Actually, I was kind of editing stuff. Okay, we're going to Newport Beach, and it's 73 southbound between MacArthur and University. A ladder reported there in the middle traffic lane. Get a run a traffic break to get that out of your way. In the meantime, just a little bit slow as you approach. KFI in the Sky is sponsored by injury attorney Superwoman, Superlawyer.com. Jeff Baugh, check of the 10.
Yeah, from the pop-up park, this is a little bigger than a ladder. It's in your way. It's a transition that's completely shut down now. It's been here for quite some time, but we just took a look at it, and finally tow trucks are on the scene trying to clear. But it's East 10, the eastbound San Bernardino Freeway transition to the north of 605. That's the only one that's shut down. Now, the freeway is fine going by. Everybody's kind of looking, so be careful. But if that's what you needed, before you get there, get off and back up to Lower Azusa or Ramona, any of those, get you to 605, and you go past the 605 again, off at Baldwin Park, north up to the 605, get the job done for you. 605 itself, not too bad, still a little slow coming down from the 60. And some good news if you're leaving the East LA Interchange right now, South 5, we just came up on, there was a stall at Triggs, that's just south of the 710, it was under the railroad tracks there, where it just cleared just about 2 minutes ago, CHP and Freeway Surface Control. So a little slow out of East LA. Once you get past 710, speeds will improve. Injured in an accident, visit Superwoman, Superlawyer.com. Jeff Baugh, KFI in the Sky.
Good to wrecking Colton on the 10 westbound at the 215 connector. Everything out of traffic lanes, looking pretty good for your drive. KFI in the Sky helps get you there faster. I'm Robin Banks.
Is there a better name than Robin Banks? I say no. I say no way.
Hey, we may have wrapped up most of what's going on with this pandemic, but there are a lot of hangover effects. And if you or your family's been financially impacted by this, it's not your fault. There are some new state laws that have been passed to help you out.
Yeah, if you've fallen behind on your mortgage or you've got a bunch of credit card or business debt, listen up. Our friends at Oak Tree Law know every letter of these new laws, and there are some real examples of how they've been able to help our listeners.
Here's just one of them. A nurse from Torrance had her hours cut because of COVID, and she was hit with medical issues of her own. She then racked up $160,000 in debt and fell behind on her mortgage. And with this new law, she was able to get current on the mortgage and eliminate the bad debt.
There was a real estate agent, her husband there in Pasadena. Their income stopped when the pandemic hit. Their second mortgage was threatening to foreclose. They had $75,000 worth of credit card and business debt. This new law helped protect their home and eliminate the debt.
It's affected all of us in some way, but there is life-changing help available with one absolutely free call to Oak Tree Law. 800-542-2949. 800-542-2949. That's 800-542-2949, or visit oaktreelaw.com.
SoCal weather from KFI. It's a partly cloudy day ahead. Has a range from the mid-60s to the low 80s. More of the same tomorrow. We'll make the low 90s for the weekend. And by next week, we could see highs in the low 100s. We leave local, live from the KFI 24-hour newsroom. I'm Jennifer Jones-Lee.
Hello?
Hello.
Hey, who's this?
Who's this? It's your Auntie June.
Oh, what's up, Auntie?
Your drum group. Were you practicing last night?
Yeah.
It's a little quiet.
What?
How many people are in it?
Six.
I thought so. It did not sound like it last night. Sounded like dog water.
What's that supposed to mean?
Jokes, sonny, jokes. But let me just say, we could definitely tell there was a six of you.
Well, only three of us got the COVID-19 vaccine, so we had to do what we could.
Well, as the leader of the group, you need to be that positive influence and help them all get vaccinated. Maybe give them a ride to the appointment, or a call reminding them.
Yeah, you're right. I'll let the others know. The vaccines are safe and effective. Plus, anyone 12 and older is eligible to get vaccinated now.
Attaboy. Now start making those calls before I do.
No way. I'm on it.
We can do this. Go to vaccines.gov to find vaccines near you. Paid for by the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services.
Hey, it's Conway here. Are you looking to sell your home fast without doing any repairs? Then you need to call my friends at Sunday. Sunday will buy your home as is and give you the best possible price. Sunday buys homes off-market in any condition. Here's how it works. If you have a dated property or an inherited property that you can't or don't want to keep, or even a house with structural issues, or a house that you simply don't want to fix up in order to sell, call Sunday to get your no-obligation cash offer. With Sunday, you don't have the hassle with showings, cleanings, repairs, or even realtor fees. Sunday will give you an immediate cash offer and can close on your timeline in as quick as 10 days. The process is so easy, you can even get a $10,000 cash advance if you need cash prior to closing. So go to Sundae.com. That's S-U-N-D-A-E.com. That's Sundae.com. S-U-N-D-A-E.com. Or call them. 800-25-OFFER. That's 800-25-OFFER.
I feel incredible because I called 1-800-WEST-MEDICAL.
Live and local.
KFI AM 640.
An iHeart radio station.
I was gonna go to class before I got high.
Come on, y'all.
Check it out. I could have cheated and I could have passed. But I got high.
My roommate in college used to sing this all the time. High.
Wait.
He got high a lot.
And then sang the song?
Yes.
To me, that seems a little overdone.
Right? It's, what's the word, choogy?
Yeah.
Right?
Choogy.
Yeah.
Good word. Gary and Shannon, KFI AM 640, live everywhere on the iHeartRadio app. In for Handle. He's coming up at 8 o'clock, by the way. He's going to let us know how things have been going. Talk about his surgery, among other things. We may get another Republican in the recall election. Assemblyman Kevin Kiley has become the latest to announce that he's considering getting in on this. Right now, it looks like Kevin Faulkner, the former San Diego mayor, sort of the leader when it comes to Republicans. The question is, number one, will Gavin Newsom be recalled? Here's another one. When will he be? When will this recall election actually make it to the ballot?
Reporters traveling to the UK ahead of President Biden's first overseas trip, 8-day trip, which told you about earlier, were delayed 7 hours after their chartered plane was overrun by cicadas. D.C. area, one of the many parts of the country confronting the swarm of Broad X. Large emergence of the loud 17-year insects that take to dive bombing onto moving vehicles and unsuspecting passerby. No thank you.
law enforcement agencies went through and cleared a bunch of illegal marijuana grow locations up in the Antelope Valley yesterday. What the LA County Sheriff's Department said was the largest operation ever to take place in the history of the LA County Sheriff's Department. Our Steve Gregory, was there when it happened. Steve, what's going on?
Hey, good morning, guys. How are you?
Super duper.
Well.
Yeah, good. So,
can I ask a quick question about this before you get into the details?
Sure.
Is this the first time you've seen Sheriff Villanueva try to wear a cowboy hat?
No, I've seen her a couple other times, but it's the first time that I actually got to hang out with him and with the cowboy hat on.
Okay.
So when he was talking about this, it turned into the Wild Wild West. It was kind of funny watching him with that hat on walk around talking about how this had turned into the Wild Wild West. So it was kind of funny.
He was playing the part.
Yeah, exactly. But also,
did you get any to-go bags?
He's not answering.
He's just giggling.
Yeah, I know.
I think I got my answer.
The But I will tell you, the reason he wears that hat, have you guys seen the mark on his lip?
No.
Oh, is it skin cancer?
Yeah.
That's right.
He had skin cancer removed a few months ago.
Oh, that sucks.
And he had a chunk of his lip cut out and sewn back together. So he's being very cautious and careful about it. So he's always wearing a hat when he's out on the field like that.
That's
so. So I get this call on Monday afternoon, and I was supposed to go to the Venice Beach event yesterday with some of the Sheriff's Department's homeless task force. And they're like, I know you're supposed to go down to Venice, but I think we have something bigger for you. And I said, okay, what's going on? They're like, well, how would you like to go along on this undercover sting on tomorrow morning? And I said, well, sure. You know, what are the details? They laid it out for me. They couldn't really tell me much because they wanted to keep everything a secret. And I'm telling you, you know, when you get that many cops together at one time, there were over 400 cops gathered yesterday morning inside a church in way the most northern part of Lancaster, and they were getting this briefing. And I want to give you a little flavor of it because I was there yesterday morning. Jacob and I were there at like 4 a.m. listening to this briefing, and this is a little bit of how the sheriff was kind of pepping up the crowd.
We're starting to get the reports from the community members, most importantly. Kids who cannot play at their athletic events in this field because of just the odor was just destroying the entire thing. They had to just work out indoors. Farmers, alfalfa farmers, in the middle of the night, being 211 at gunpoint for water. Who would ever thought of that would be a hazard as a farmer? That's how bad the situation got. People in the night being confronted by armed people carrying or driving truckloads of weed, like when they go to the market. And I want to say this is going to be one of those moments in time where, one, we're engaging in the largest operation the Sheriff's Department has ever done. And this is going to dwarf all other operations.
And he really got him fired up when he said, and he used some curse words. It was kind of funny. He used some curse words and got him all fired up. It was pretty interesting to get him riled up.
Over weed?
Over the operation. And okay. See, here's the thing. You know, I was getting some comments on social media, and everyone's all fired up about weed. It's like, all this over weed? No, it's not over weed. It's right. Over what it takes to make the weed.
It's the criminal organization that is doing this. I mean, the weed itself may be sort of an innocuous, depending on how you feel about it, but it's the criminal organization, it's the weapons, it's the threats, it's the human trafficking. I mean, there's so much more involved
than just... Well, it's the stolen water, and that's the big thing. Millions of gallons of water... just for one area, for one crop. And what they're doing is, you hear the sheriff sitting there explaining, is that they'll show up at nighttime. He gave this one story about an alfalfa farmer, and for those that don't know, alfalfa farmers typically like to harvest their crops overnight because of the humidity and the moisture. And when these farmers are trying to do it, when they show up, all they're met by are guys with AK-47 standing there watching the water truck siphon the water out of the irrigation ditches. Or in some cases, they'll pull up to fire hydrants, and they'll just tap into the fire hydrants, and they fill up these water trucks, drive back to the marijuana grows, and fill up these big tanks that they've got sitting off to the side. And that causes a lot of problems. So, you know, this is what makes me laugh when everyone's like, oh, I can't believe they're doing all this. Don't they have better things to do? It's like, well, you just said it, Gary. It's human trafficking. It's the criminal enterprise. And that's what they were going after here.
What do they do with $50 million worth of weed?
Well, here's the thing, Shannon. That $50 million was just at the one location. They served at least 40 warrants yesterday, 40 locations yesterday. In 2020, they estimated 150 locations, and by this year already, more than 500 locations. So they're doing it in two ways. They take it outside in some big dump somewhere, and the guy wouldn't tell me. And then they light it on fire.
I wonder why.
and then the other thing they do is, I've been told that they also dig a big pit now, and they pour some sort of an organic chemical on it that just kind of destroys it and turns it into mulch. So it's kind of funny. But I do want to play a little audio for you from one of the guys that was there. His team was one of the first in on this big operation.
We've got plants in various stages of growth, budded plants, some immature plants. There's a few greenhouses that were harvested. Upon arrival, as the entry team drove in, there was about three people that ran from the location and fled. Our airship was overhead and was able to maintain a visual on them. Once we cleared the greenhouses and detained several people that were inside, we redirected our focus and sent our containment units with the airship to detain the folks that were that ran from the greenhouse. This is one of the largest grows that we've seen this year in our county. I don't believe that we've ever actually been to a grow larger than this in the last several years.
And one of the things I was able to do yesterday, which was kind of cool, is I took my drone up overhead, and I just sent you guys on your phones. I just sent you a picture. I took a screenshot of just this one operation, and from my drone video footage that we're going to post later today. But if you take a look at that photo I just texted you,
I'm looking.
Yeah.
Wow.
And then you open it up, and then those are all the rows.
That's I didn't know you had a tattoo.
Yeah. Wow. That's a great angle. You know your angles.
And then some.
Right. This is the one that you also posted on Twitter.
Yeah, that's right. And if you zoom in on it, you can see all the cop cars down
How
there.
How is
little
this
yeah.
size of a grow operation able to thrive, being the size that it is, and nobody noticed?
You know, here's the thing, though, Shannon. So most of this operation was being built and up and running during pandemic. So there was no activity, no action, nothing happening anywhere. No one was going out. But you had in the cloak of darkness these guys running around with these water trucks.
I mean, even if you flew over, you'd see this thing, right?
Well, that's right. And so that was sort of the pivotal point for them when the people were starting to complain, also to Congressman Mike Garcia's office, who's the guy for that area up there. He was getting a lot of calls, too, because I remember getting some press releases from him. And then they finally got together, he and the sheriff, and then they took a flight. They've taken a series of flights, and they've been doing this survey and counting them. And then they go down on the ground and do some surveillance, and they realize those are illegal operations. And then they've been putting this plan together for about a year now.
Well, Steve shared the picture with us. We also posted it up on Handel's page on the KFI website, where Steve has that picture, a couple of his tweets, and some more information about the actual raids yesterday, including the special report that you put together.
You will have some of that drone footage and some more exclusive audio coming up later.
Love it. Thanks, Steve.
Bye, guys.
Steve Gregory there with the latest. Again, the huge, huge marijuana busts yesterday, driven by the LA County Sheriff's Department.
My roommate from college is mad that I dined him off about getting high 20 years ago. Thank you, Steve.
Let's go do this.
Gary and Shannon will continue. And your social media is diming you off to hackers. Why do I still hear Steve breathing? Can we pod him down?
It's just in your head now.
That was weird.
He is in your head. Gary and Shannon will continue in for Handle today. Jennifer Jones-Lee has an update.
Vice President Harris is back from her first international trip. She sat down with Mexico's president yesterday, a day after visiting Guatemala. A White House COVID-19 advisor spending his last day on the job, Andy Slavitt, says he always considered it a temporary role. And the Breakfast of Champions is celebrating a boxing legend. Wheaties is marking 100 years with a box featuring Muhammad Ali. It's the first in a limited edition Century Box series. We've got a trouble spot on the 91. We'll look at it with EKFI in the sky next.
We were just talking about stealing water. Water is just an incredibly precious resource. We start drinking more of it as it gets warmer. We're using more water at home and our marijuana grows, all of it.
Imagine if you had a life source whole house water system, how much you'd be able to water your weed.
Reusable bottled water, when you fill any reusable bottle or glass, filtered water straight from any tap in your house with life source whole house water system.
I bet you haven't thought about the changes in your shower, because that whole house water system includes that tap as well, and we're talking softer skin. You're not going to have to color treat your hair as much with this water.
Their whole house water systems also require no maintenance. You could say goodbye to those filter changes or monthly tank exchanges. And if you add hard water, they can help with that too.
A life source water system gets rid of the odor and taste of chlorine. They don't use salt or chemicals. With LifeSource water, you are buying direct from the factory as well.
The LifeSource water team provides a customized water solution that is specific to your home. And that includes installation and customer service support.
The factory has served Southern California for 37 years. All products are made in the USA.
They're looking to hire, too. Great career opportunities at LifeSource. So call them today for full service, full confidence in your water again.
Call 800-334-5009, 800-334-5009, or visit LifeSourceWater.com.
LifeSource Water. Taste and feel the difference.
Lowe's is your go-to for great gardening values every day. Select bagged mulch is now just $2.88 a bag. Shop online and pick up in-store. Lowe's, home to the best part of summer. Selection and product availability vary by location while supplies last, U.S. only.
Here's SoCal weather from KFI. Partly cloudy with highs...